Marcus has made a remarkable start yesterday. Let's check out where we are headed for the year and for the next 24 months. Starting as well as our market master for the day, Jyoti Agarwal, Head of Research at Bank of America, Merrill Lynch. Good morning, Jyoti. Day before yesterday, up until Friday, a bunch of people were telling us that we have already seen the highs for the year. Would you concur or disagree?
So obvious that will be higher than where we are today by the time we end the year. But a lot of the returns are probably going to be back-ended. So, obviously, the first half is going to be a flattish year for the markets, and probably most of the returns for the year will be made in the second half.
When you say returns, you expecting earnings growth to show some traction later on? In which quarter do you expect earnings growth will actually show that they returned?
Absolutely. If you see the last quarter was horrible in terms of earnings growth. So it was the first time in 20 quarters that we actually got a drop in profit and a negative growth. I think by the time we end the last quarter of this calendar year, we'll probably be back into that double-digit sort of earnings growth. And more critical, I think, is by the time we come towards the end of the year, hopefully we start seeing some green shoots in the economy. So the hope will be that next year will be a very strong year for earnings and a very strong year for the economy. And that is what is really going to lead to markets heading higher.
Okay. Jyoti, hi, good morning. We are going through your notes that you put out, and we read that you have a Sensex target at 54,000 by the end of 2018. That will make a lot of retail investors very happy, I'm sure. But just take us through what your sectoral approach would be. What do you think could be the leaders of this market, not just in 1 year, but in the next 1 to 2 years' time?
That's not this way for about a year ago, saying that the markets will double over the next 4 or 5 years. And so the whole thought process was that the economy will pick up. If you see earnings and if you see margins are at 18-year low, and obviously this margin will revert to mean, and that is what is really going to drive the markets much higher than where we were. Like everything will double over the next 4 or 5 years in terms of markets. Sectors which will drive this are going to be the domestic sectors. So basically, a big change from the last 4 or 5 years where we saw a lot of the export-led sectors doing well. Actually, over the next 4 or 5 years, we'll see the domestic sector doing well. So whether it be autos, infrastructure, cement, and the banks, those are the sectors which will really drive this stuff over the next 5 years.
Do you expect better traction this year itself to be triggered by the government, Jyoti? We are not seeing too much of that even corporate sector activity, but it's private sector activity. We haven't really seen consumption pick up for maybe 2 or 3 years, showed some bit of positivity, but not a whole lot. Do you think the trigger will come from, say, smart cities, construction, or freight corridor, or railways, or some such government-led infrastructure moves?
This is like a 5-year view, and in that 5-year view, our thought process was that the first leg will be the urban consumption pickup, the infrastructure will be more back-ended. Of course, what happens is the stock market, typically the stock prices start moving up 3-4 quarters before we actually start seeing earnings growth. So this is the last quarter of the year where we got a massive rejecting in the market on that hope that things will start improving. This is the year of consolidation, probably where everybody starts saying, okay, now show me the earnings, show me the recovery in the economy. And that's why I would think those markets will be in bond for the next 6 months while we might start absorbing and waiting for some more positive news flow. So what we're seeing is there is a pickup in activity. So, more projects are getting tendered. We get monthly data, so if you look at it, we are probably running 30-40% more than what we were at the corresponding period last year in terms of road upgrade. So there is a pickup there. In railways, you can see visibly that there is some pickup which is happening. Now, a lot of this we are slow process. It's not like a quick start where everything starts to pick up immediately. So that's why by the time we end the calendar year, we'll probably have more hope that these things are actually translating into order books for companies, so next year is probably a better year for the economy and for earnings.
Okay. I know you track the emerging market fund flow very closely, Jyoti. What's the sense you're getting about what the way forward would be like, and how India would be stacked up amongst the other emerging markets? Because there is a fear that some of the money could move out of India and into China.
Yes, you know, like one of the big things why we are not as positive in the market near term is that India is a very, very consensus overweight market. So if you look at flows today and you look at gen fund positioning, India is by far the most overweight market. Most people are like 450 to 500 basis points overweight India. So to that extent, if you see now, incremental fund flow to India is going to be relatively slower. In fact, we saw this last year also. So last year was a great year for markets. It was a great year when Modi came in, and so there was a lot of euphoria all over. But the actual foreign flows to India last year were lower than the flows the previous year or the year before that. So in a year in which, you know, there was so much euphoria in India, actual money flow was much lower because, you know, people were already sitting on a very overweight position in India. And this year will be very similar, where people are already overweight, so for most people to put incremental flows in India will be like it will be a slow effort. I think we'll end the year positive flows, but it probably will be similar, maybe slightly lower than last year.
So the first piece of growth is urban consumption, Jyoti. We haven't seen too much of evidence for that. Is it therefore hinged on an expectation of rate cuts?
Yes, so that is hinged on the fact that one is will get rate cuts. It's no longer expectations. I think that a 50 basis point rate cut from the RBI, we hopefully will have some more before the end of the year. So there will be rate cuts. Banks will probably be transmitting some of the rate cuts to the consumer. And so that will be one leg of it. The other leg will be expectation that the economy is picking up, some signs that the economy is picking up, which means, you know, wage growth and salary increases will be higher in the economy. So that will translate to more spending power in the economy.
Okay. You recently added that pharma as an overweight into your portfolio as well. But for an investor who, I suppose, has not made enough gains or not made gains in the pharma sector, is it too late to enter now, or do you think the large cap still warrants some attention?
Yes, my whole logic for us was, you know, like last year we had given pharma and software some overweights because our whole thing was nobody owns the domestic cyclical, so that's the space to be. With the other year we added pharma, and the logic again was this is now going to be a period, the next 6 months, investors will start saying, show me the earnings. And so some of the domestic cyclicals which have had a great run, probably are still good longer term, but they may consolidate a bit. And that was the reason that we had pharma back. I like pharma as a sector because, you know, there's an earnings growth there, and I think there will be very visible earnings growth over the next few years also. So even if valuations are a little expensive, what we have is a very strong, steady earnings growth. So probably, you know, if earnings over the next 3 and a half years double out, we'll probably make that sort of return in the market, maybe slightly lower than earnings growth.
So what about IT then?
IT, you know, so between the two, the reason I prefer pharma or IT is that I think the earnings growth in pharma will be stronger than IT. So both are even more than similar valuations. And IT, I think, will have lower earnings growth than what pharma will have over the next 3 to 4 years.
Okay.
So that's the reason why I prefer pharma or IT. We are looking at IT in our portfolio just now because, you know, again, we think that there's a phase where some of these sectors will do relatively better while, you know, people start absorbing the gains in the domestic cyclicals. But after two, pharma is clearly my preference.
So unsurprisingly, it is the mid-caps that showed the best gains in the year that ends today. Some of the other ancillaries giving you 300% even plus gains. I know it's a little difficult to shift sectorally in the mid-cap space, but if you have to, would mid-caps still give you higher beta, higher gains than big caps in, say, the next 12, 24 months? And which sectors would they be?
Yes, I think, you know, over the next, like, probably in a 3 year time frame, 2 year time frame, I think the mid caps will do better than the large caps. And basically, it's, you know, the mid caps in each of these sectors will probably do better than the large caps in the sector. So probably some of the mid caps which will do the best are going to be the domestic cyclicals, which will do better than the large cap cyclicals also. I think the next 3 to 4 months, 6 months, it probably is a tougher call. I think probably the large caps may be better than the mid caps in the next few months because, you know, mid caps have had a great run. They are great when the economy picks up, but if the economy doesn't pick up, then, you know, the same thing hits them on the downside, but their earnings are more vulnerable to disappointment. So I think the next 3 months, 6 months, probably it's going to be the large caps which will do well. But maybe at that time in disappointment, you should try to make crops.
Okay, that point is taken. I noticed from your top guys, you have BPCL as well. Oil marketing companies are, or rather have been in a sweet spot for a while. What kind of gains do you expect to see on the earnings front, and also in terms of how much, you know, overall under recoveries could fall, etc.?
Well, so even for the oil marketing companies, the story was very simple, and I think a lot of people played it last year, but they were running into very low margins because of the whole subsidy situation. The margins have gone up a lot, and that's why, you know, earnings could really more than double probably over the next 18 months for them. Some of it is priced in already in the market, but to them, just the fact that these become, I call them like they've become normal companies, in the sense now we can forecast the earnings more sensibly than we used to, because subsidy used to be one big component for them.
Mm-hmm.
So the fact that they are normally coming, now we can look at earnings very normally to them, and that's the reason why I think they'll do well.
Okay, let me round it off for our viewers, JP. How do you split the 100 note in terms of sector and debts?
Okay, so you know, we have like our model portfolio, I guess. So in some sense, we do tracking of a benchmark to that extent, you know, the 100 rupees is split in the more picture there. But banks, autos, cement are clearly at three big old rates, oil and, you know, infrastructure.
That's not 30-20 cents.
These are the five big old rates we have. Yeah, it's, you know, actually a bit linked to the benchmark which you are following.
Okay.
So the reason why banks is like more than 30%. It's just that it's a very, very big part of the benchmark. Autos is the other big component which we have. And, you know, cement is obviously a very small number. That's why we have only like 3% over there. How are the other one which we are away from just now? But like I said, that's like more like a 3-month, 6-month tactical call till we get a bit more comfortable and visibility on earnings in the domestic cyclicals. So that would be like probably another 10%.
I'm sure 100 rupees is a very small change to you, so it's hard for you to buy for me. But I'm just joking. But thanks, JP, for giving us your view. And you have a good, there's a long weekend coming up, so you have a good weekend. Thank you for your time, as always.